I suppose it would be 30 years ago that I first came across Miller Nicholson. I started collecting when I was about 19, 20. I'd just left my job in the Treasury and I'd gone into the private sector, a substantial pay increase. The difference between the two salaries I would put into something to remember the change, and I bought an E.C. Quayle painting, and I started collecting then, sort of built my way up as I could afford, and I came across, I've got it in my lounge, I think it's a small 7 by 3.5 inch, 4 inch watercolour by Miller Nicholson. I had it cleaned, and down at Cross Four Ways there was like a dub that the artist used to go down there and paint, and when you see it, you see he was using individual horsehair for some of his work, and the atmosphere and the quality. And I realised then he was the master, and sadly, most other artists that I see pale into insignificance compared with him. I didn't necessarily have the funds to collect his work, and in those days there was a couple of really wealthy people that were throwing money at it, and as I say, I could but admire his work, and then slowly over the years I've built up a modest collection of his style. I mean, I think as we go through life, our taste buds maybe change. What I liked first about Miller Nicholson was, I suppose, his Pre-Raphaelite style of detail. I'm a very detailed facts, figures sort of person. There's one of the fishing fleet in Peel Harbour. When you look at the masts, the straight line, he never used a ruler. You know, he was phenomenal. And then, I suppose, as my taste buds, you could argue, matured or changed slightly, and liked he became more impressionistic in his style. I suppose if I was to nail my colours to the mast about why John Miller Nicholson is so special, it's the way he put atmosphere into his paintings. In 1882, he was lucky to have a good friend in John Ruskin, who was arts and crafts Mr. Big, I suppose, really, a bit of an artist himself. And he persuaded him to go to Italy to tour all the top artists, to look at various styles of work. Behind me are two 1875 paintings. John Ruskin used to buy some of his best works in the 70s and take them off to London galleries, and I think they were sold for 5 guineas or something. That was his real quality work from his Pre-Raphaelite days. The details, phenomenally good. And I'm delighted that two of them I've got. They came back from London and I bought them at auction. After 1882-ish, he moved into the more impressionist style. And I wasn't around in 1882, but I'm told that it was because of that trip to Italy that he saw different styles and decided he was going to alter his style to the more impressionist. And he did. But I've got two paintings of his work in the impressionist style. And wow, they really are fantastic. And I'm glad and honoured to have them in my collection. Mm-hmm. To me, there is no artist living or pre to paint on the Isle of Man can hold a candle to John Miller Nicholson. So, you know, that's one of my biggest regrets, is that John Miller Nicholson has not had the recognition that he deserves. He was a painfully shy man. I think when he painted canvases for some of the shows at the Gaiety, and they wanted him to come on stage and applaud him for his for his scenery work that he painted, he was so shy he went out the side door. Lady Locke, who'd spotted his work and introduced him to John Ruskin, they got him exhibited at the Royal Academy, but he was painfully shy. He just didn't like crowds, and I'm absolutely convinced that if he'd been more forthcoming in meeting people and speaking to him, explaining his work and going away, I'm not sure, to effectively help sell it when it was in a gallery, then John Miller Nicholson would have been one of Britain and the UK, the world's foremost painters, because the quality is absolutely phenomenal.